In the midst of a century of murderous pogroms and crushing poverty, a wise mystic sought to rescue the downtrodden and revitalize Judaism. Known as the Baal Shem Tov, or Master of the Good Name, his joyous spirituality revolutionized Judaism and nearly tore it in half. The 17th and 18th centuries were a brutal time to be Jewish in Eastern Europe. The Khmelnytsky pogroms left tens of thousands of Jews dead, with the survivors struggling to rebuild. In its wake, a massive following of Jews flocked to the charismatic Rabbi Shabtai Tzvi in hopes of redemption, only to be left hopeless and betrayed when he converted to Islam. Many Jews were so poor that they couldn't spare time to study the Torah or practice their religion. Into this gap stepped a most unusual man, the Baal Shem Tov. The early decades of his life are shrouded in mystery. He may have studied with secretive Jewish mystics, and he likely supported himself by mining for clay. What is known is that he began preaching at the age of 36. Stories quickly spread of his inspirational wisdom and his ability to miraculously heal the sick. The Baal Shem Tov emphasized that God was in every aspect of life, from the mighty Torah to a single leaf. While the Baal Shem Tov supported religious study, or what he called Torah of the mind, he primarily focused his teachings on achieving Torah of the heart. This approach meant that farmers could connect to God just as easily in their fields as in venerated study halls. He argued that the greatest access to divinity flowed through the tzaddikim, or righteous Jews of the generation. These tzaddikim were considered direct conduits to God and provided guidance in all areas of life. Above all, he taught that the greatest Torah genius and scholar and the most simple Jew are loved equally by God. For the Baal Shem Tov, the best way to embrace God was by praying with feeling. While his approach was not new, he emphasized proper intention in prayer, even at the expense of Jewish law. He also encouraged peasants to pray about practical problems, like asking for God's help with a sick cow. Most of all, he filled his worship services with jubilant songs and dance to serve God through joy. The Baal Shem Tov's accessible and appealing approach to Judaism resonated across the villages of Eastern Europe, coalescing into the Hasidic or saintliness movement. Followers flocked to his side during his life, but his teachings took off after his death under the guidance of his successor, Dov Ber, the Maggid of Mezrich. The Maggid's piety was so great that the Baal Shem Tov's own son declared him the new leader of the movement. The Maggid sent out emissaries that spread Hasidism to Poland, Galicia, and Russia, inspiring a generation of Jews. Hasidism spread like wildfire, at least until it reached Lithuania, home of the most respected rabbi in Eastern Europe. Rabbi Elijah Kramer, known as the Vilna Gaon, or genius from Vilna, first gained attention as a child prodigy with a photographic memory and an unrivaled passion for study. He was such a giant of the Torah that one of the greatest rabbis of the 19th century said, "There is one star that shines in our firmament, the Gaon of Vilna." The Vilna Gaon and his followers became known as the Mitnagdim, or opponents of Hasidism. They rejected Hasidism's choice to prioritize prayer over study, believing it undermined Torah wisdom as the essential path to divinity. They also felt that the Hasidim were creating rifts in the community by adopting unnecessary stringencies in ritual observance. Furthermore, the Vilna Gaon feared the Hasidic movement was leading towards a heretical belief in pantheism, the idea that everything is God. With the Hasidic movement growing more and more popular, the Vilna Gaon became convinced that it would cause a terrible rift among the Jewish people and lead them away from long-standing Jewish values. In an attempt to prevent this, the Vilna Gaon denounced Hasidism as heresy and demanded its followers be uprooted from all places, never to be mentioned again. Hasidic leaders tried desperately to meet with him to change his mind, but he refused to see them. The Hasidim then struck back, claiming that the Vilna Gaon's teachings were full of lies. The fight continued for decades, accusations piling on accusations. Although the war between the Mitnagdim and the Hasidim was vicious, in the long run it strengthened both movements. Opposition united the Hasidim into a close-knit community and forced them to moderate their more extreme positions, restricting the power of the tzaddikim and deepening their dedication to Torah study. Meanwhile, the struggle inspired the Mitnagdim to create the first yeshiva that strived to make Jewish learning more accessible. Originally spearheaded by one of the Vilna Gaon's students, Rabbi Chaim of Elozhin, this inclusive yeshiva system is a central feature of Judaism to this day. Hasidism continues to thrive, but the influence of the Baal Shem Tov extends even further. His call to find God, even in the harshest conditions, consoled Jews and helped them survive. His lessons have provided inspiration to modern Jews all across the spectrum. Even the Mitnagdim eventually studied the Hasidim's works and incorporated their melodies of prayer. The Baal Shem Tov's legacy still lives on through both his followers and his opponents, calling on Jews around the world to celebrate their Judaism and worship with joy.